In this video, I'll walk through some phase changes of the compound water, specifically converting ice at a certain temperature all the way to liquid, and then bringing that liquid up to temperature, and then converting that liquid into steam, and then bringing that steam up to temperature. So the idea is we have 500 grams of ice, which begins at negative 10 degrees Celsius. And ultimately, we will turn that into steam at 120 degrees Celsius. And the question is, how much heat in kilojoules is required to do that? And we have all of this information. Now, you can do this with any compound as long as you have all of this information. This, we have the information here for specifically the H2O molecule, the H2O compound, which is our water. So, we need to first bring this ice up to temperature. We have a block of ice, let's say, and it's at negative 10 degrees Celsius. And I'm going to walk through step by step exactly what we're doing. We're bringing that up to 0 degrees Celsius. So that's our first step. The next step, and I'm going to color code this because then I'm going to come over here and walk through the calculations in the same color. The next step is the heat of fusion, and that is we're going to change that ice into liquid. So we haven't done enough just to bring it up to 0 degrees Celsius. We have to add a little bit more energy. This is kind of a funny thing to think about. We have to add a little bit more energy to actually turn that ice into liquid. And that's going to be the heat of fusion. I'll walk through all of that. The next step of turning that into liquid, now we're at liquid, which is still at 0 degrees Celsius, but the next step after that is to heat that liquid up all the way up to the boiling point, which we know is 100 degrees Celsius. Okay, so we've gotten the liquid up to that temperature, and that will be right at the boiling point, but we're not far enough. We need then to vaporize this liquid into steam. So we're going to turn this into steam, and it'll still be at 100 degrees at this step, 100 degrees steam, and then finally in the end we will take that steam and increase its temperature another 20 degrees up to 120 degrees Celsius. So we have these steps, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 steps, and we have the information. After we figure out what's going on, that as we did, now it's not going to be that tough. So here we go. To increase the temperature of the ice, we need the specific heat of ice, that is how much energy the ice takes in order to increase its temperature. That's what the specific heat is. Well, it takes in, I'll write S sub ice, it takes in 2.108 kilojoules for every kilogram raised 1 degree Celsius. That's what that notation means. Now, all we need to do in order to get our kilojoules out of this is just convert some units. So, what do I need to multiply it in order to get rid of the degrees Celsius? Well, that's how many degrees Celsius are we changing? We are changing 10 degrees Celsius, so I'll put that there. We also need to get rid of the kilograms, so I'm going to multiply by the number of kilograms. Don't be fooled here. We've got 500 grams, which we're not fooled. We know that's 0.500 kilograms. It's a little bit over a pound. So that is 0.5 kilograms. And multiply that through. The kilograms get canceled out. And in the end, then we have 10.54 kilojoules. That's how much energy it takes to increase ice 10 degrees. Next, we're going to turn this into liquid. This is called the heat of fusion. And that number is given to us right there. The notation is delta H sub FUS. Heat of fusion, we're told that is 334 kilojoules. It takes 334 kilojoules to convert 1 kilogram of ice into liquid. So all we need to do is multiply by our sample size, and that is 0.5 kilograms. That will cancel the kilograms. And that gives us, I'm going to write it over here so we can line it all up. That gives us 167 kilojoules. 167 kilojoules to convert a half a kilogram into half a kilogram of ice into a half a kilogram of liquid. Next, we're going to raise the temperature of the liquid, and that is the for that we need the specific heat of water. That's pretty high, and it's really interesting. Actually, water is a really very interesting compound, just how much heat it can take in without actually raising its temperature. So it needs to take in quite a bit just to raise its temperature. Well, here it is. We have the specific heat of the liquid, just water. I'll write water here. Specific heat of liquid water, that equals 4.187 kilojoules to raise 1 kilogram of water 1 degree Celsius. How much are we raising it? Well, we are increasing that temperature 100 degrees Celsius from 0 all the way to 100. And how big is our sample size? How many kilograms do we have? We have 0.5 kilograms. So multiply all that and we get 209.4 kilojoules. Okay, we're moving along. Next, we need to convert that liquid at 100 degrees into steam at 100 degrees. And to do that, we need the heat of vaporization. That's this, denoted delta H sub VAP. And that heat of vaporization, it's given to us, is 2,260 kilojoules for every 1 kilogram. We don't have a full kilogram. We have a half of a kilogram, 0.5 kilograms. So it's not going to take 2,260. It's going to take 1,130. 1,130 kilojoules to convert the 500 grams or 0.5 kilograms of liquid into steam. Now it's still at 100 degrees, so we have to do a little bit more work here. We're going to raise that 100 degree steam up to 120 degree steam, and for that we need the specific heat of steam. How much heat or energy is required to raise the temperature of steam? That is S sub steam, all right here, and that equals 1.996 kilojoules for every kilogram to raise it 1 degree Celsius. We don't have all of the full kilogram, but here we go. First, with the degree Celsius, we are raising it 20 degrees. That's right here, from 100 to 120. So we are raising it 20 degrees Celsius. And next, we have to multiply by the number of kilograms, and that is 0.5 kilograms. And multiply that, and we get 19.96 kilojoules. So all of these steps are all of the steps that we are taking. I'm out of room in the bottom, so I'm going to write the answer right up here. And rounding to four significant figures, I have 1,537 kilojoules that is required to take the ice at negative 10 degrees Celsius, and this is a half a kilogram of ice, and raise it all the way up, raise its temperature, and then turn it into liquid, and then raise the temperature of the liquid, and then turn the liquid into steam, and then raise the temperature of the steam. All of those steps takes that much energy, and that is a nice example for phase changes. I hope you found that helpful. If you did, consider liking it or sharing it with a friend.